You want to avoid acne, you have to know how to remove your makeup. Stay tuned. So we are starting today to remove makeup. Because I did some YouTube videos, so I have a lovely, lovely makeup artist that is here. He did my makeup for today. Thank you very much. So, and now we have to remove it, because in your daily life, honestly, I never wear makeup. I don't have the time for it, but if you do, and some of you probably are really excellent at putting makeup on. I see so many YouTube videos of tremendous, fantastic how you put it on. I would not be able to do it. But nevertheless, you have to remove your makeup in the evening because otherwise you get pimples. Because with the heat, during the sleeping time and during the 8 hours you hopefully sleep, all the bacteria have time to actually developing, growing and going inside and making these cute little pimples. So in order to remove them, you have to know how to think actually how to remove them. Because pigment and makeup is actually very, very fatty. So fat has to be removed with fat on the first place. So the best way is actually kind of milk, right? Milk is removing makeup quite well because their milk is fatty. So Leticia, give me the milk. I put my coat away. I hate coats. And voila. So whatever milk you're using, I have now a Nivea one, but you could use any other one, even this here in Switzerland from Mikro or Coop, in Germany from maybe DM or other kind of brand, doesn't really matter. It has to be a kind of milk. So something that has a little bit of fat inside. And milk, as you know, is a little bit fat. So what you do, you put it then under your face and kind of trying to get everything out. So of course I forgot now a towel, but therefore we have we have these little guys I call 3-in-1 towels. I love them. I love to death them. Particular, I must admit, are these from Balea. It's a DM kind of company. You talk a lot about this one. They do have some good ones, and this is which I do like, because this is a really nicely softly one. If you figure out some other brands, use them. And it's really cool to take everything out before you use water. So using water, of course, is very important. And using then a fruit acid foam is actually better, also not just to remove all the fat pigment, but also afterwards all the dead skin cells on top. So I try to do it a little bit better in front of the mirror in the bathroom, because it's otherwise a little bit funny to do so. And give me a second to do half of my face. Wait. Okay, before I forget, some people like me never normally use a foundation, just eye makeup. And to remove eye makeup, the best solution is actually using a 2-in-1 solution, so oil and water. You see them because they are like sometimes in different colors, and sometimes you see the liquid and the water phase in different kind of shapes, and you see the differences. And the best way is to shakey, shakey, shakey them, because then you have a micellar and emulsion. And these guys, it doesn't matter which kind of brand, there are a couple of out there, like L'Oreal, Nivea, Balea, BB, doesn't really matter. You put actually on a wet towel, on a cotton ball, put it on, and therefore you then remove, ideally, very quick, your eye makeup. Very easy, but remember to remove your makeup in order to avoid actually an overgrowth of bacterial and therefore also an over acne face. Okay, let me finish and I come back in a second. So this is the result, half makeup removed, half it's on. So remember to remove your eye makeup, use a 2-in-1 eye makeup remover, doesn't matter which kind of brand. And for the whole face, use the best one as a milk or a 2-in-1 towel before actually you wash your face and use, for example, fruit acid foam or kind of different soaps. And use a towel just for your face, a white one, not too big and not too small, just for your face to minimize all the bacteria on top in order to avoid acne. So Thank you so much. Give me some likes if you did like the information I gave you or did you like my videos. I thank Letizia, I thank Nick for all the help because I couldn't do it in motion without them. And I hope you switch me on next time. Give me please some suggestions because, as I said, I'm a dermatologist here in Zurich. I'm not a YouTuber. And therefore, it would be lovely if you could help me with suggestions what I could do better. Maybe I should speak in German the next time I'm doing, or maybe half. So thank you so much. See you next time for all the topics about lifestyle, beauty, dermatology. Thanks so much.